Another politician acquitted of plunder in the multi-billion peso pork barrel scam. This was the ruling of the Philippine Anti-Graft Court in Senator Jinggoy Estrada's case. But it found him guilty of bribery, sentencing him to 8 years to 9 years and 4 months of imprisonment, as well as indirect bribery with a sentence of 2 years and 4 months to 3 years, 6 months and 20 days. He's also suspended from holding public office and ordered to pay a 3 million peso fine. Despite the mixed decision, Estrada calls it a vindication.
I did not steal any money. I did not receive any money. That's why I would like to thank the magistrates of the Sandigan Bayan that after 1 decade, my case has already been resolved.
So it took almost 10 years.
It took almost 10 years, but I'm very, very thankful. This is a vindication of my name, and I am emerging victorious at this point. But as to the conviction of the direct and indirect bribery, I am not a lawyer. I haven't read the decision, but I am so surprised since based on the information sheet, there was no bribery or indirect or direct bribery filed in the information sheet. It is only the case of plunder. Okay. And I have been already acquitted. I have been exonerated of plunder. And I will ask my lawyers to exhaust all legal remedies, all legal options available for me.
Estrada's lawyer surprised as well by their client's conviction for lesser offenses.
We're just so happy that he was vindicated with a crime of plunder because that's the main charge against him. But of course, we are blindsided. Actually, we're confused why bribery was charged against him when it is, when, first of all, it's not included in the information and it cannot be absorbed by the crime of plunder. It's not even connected. So maybe those are the few of the grounds that we will discuss in our appeal.
Senator Estrada is accused of pocketing 183 million pesos in kickbacks in the pork barrel scam. Fellow Senator Bong Revilla was also acquitted in his separate pork barrel scam case in 2021. Estrada's colleagues at the Senate weighing in on the Sandigan Bayan's ruling on his pork barrel scam case. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says Senator Estrada has the right to exhaust all legal means. Zubiri adds, until the court's decision is final and executory, Estrada is duty-bound to serve in the upper chamber. Meanwhile, Senator Estrada's half-brother, Senator J.V. Ejercito, urges everyone to respect the wisdom of the country's justice system. A check on regional equities now. Asian markets are mostly higher after their American peers break a two-day losing streak thanks to a rally in global chipmakers. Taipei-listed shares of Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing surged 6.3%. On an upbeat 2024 revenue growth projection, its U.S. shares soared nearly 10% overnight, fueling a broad tech rally in Wall Street. Now, taking a look at the board now, Japan's Nikkei 225 leading Friday's rise, increasing by over 8%. This after Japan, the world's third largest economy, saw its December inflation cooling to its lowest level since June 2022. Chinese markets, meanwhile, are down days after Beijing's disappointing 2023 GDP report. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They're pointing to a mostly higher open as the rally in Asia is expected to spread to the region. Contracts tied to the German DAX, though, are down. Stateside now, opening calls are mixed for Wall Street after the overnight rally. Investors will be watching out for earnings results from several financial institutions. The suspension of shipping routes through the Red Sea expected to hike shipping fees by up to 15%. Now, that's according to the Philippine Economic Zone Authority. It says this could also delay by 10 days the exchange of goods between Europe and Asia. It adds the Red Sea woes would affect global trade and add to inflationary pressure across the world. But PEZA assures the public it is working with other concerned agencies to de-risk the global supply chains that may affect locators in the Philippine economy. About 10% of the world's seaborne trade goes through the Red Sea shipping route. An erstwhile Philippine finance chief backs charter amendments to allow foreign ownership of land in the country. Veteran banker and economist Gary Teves believes the move will create more jobs for Filipinos. The former Arroyo administration official also says this will allow the development of underutilized areas outside the capital region.
I feel strongly about it because having seen a number of areas in the Philippines outside of the major ones like Metro Manila, there are really quite a number of underdeveloped lands. And it would be unfortunate that these lands remain underutilized. So giving the foreign investors an opportunity to own this land. But I would stress that it will not be an obligation on the part of the owner. It's still an option. And if they prefer to sell the land, then that's fine. But if they want to just lease it, that's fine. But it should be allowed.